Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman and I'm here with Kelly Anderson and we're going to talk about Azure Security Center. Welcome back.
Awesome. Thank you, Scott. Thanks for having me. So I'm going to walk you through three things today with Azure Security Center. Mm-hmm. The first thing I'm going to show you is how it gives us unified visibility across our hybrid cloud workloads.
Cool.
The second thing is we give you several mechanisms to help you prevent threats. And one that I'm going to be showing you is just-in-time virtual machine access. Mm. And the last thing I'll show you is how Security Center helps us to detect threats and quickly respond to those threats.
And does everyone have Security Center? Do I have this already?
So that's a great question. So if you are currently an Azure customer, you can take advantage of the first thing I'm going to show you in Azure Security Center for free.
Cool.
It will always be free for you. And if you're in trial, it will still be free. And then the other features that I will show you, they're a part of our standard tier of security. Mm-hmm. And so they're free for you to use for the first 60 days.
Nice. All right, let's check them out.
Awesome. So to get to Security Center, I'm looking at the dashboard of my Azure portal, and we can see that it's built into the Azure portal. So it makes it really simple for us to find it and get started. So when I click on Security Center, because I've already set it up, this is what my overview dashboard looks like, but if I was new to Security Center, mm-hmm. I would see a welcome screen, and it would ask me to launch it, and which I would say okay. And then the next thing I would do is I would move to my security policy, and one of the tabs, it's called data collection, mm-hmm. and this is where I'm gonna go to provision the monitoring agent that will be installed on my Azure virtual machines and on-premises virtual machines, so that when I do come to my overview dashboard, I can see the security state of my Azure and on-premises resources.
All right.
So I've done that, and when I come to my overview dashboard, I can see that Security Center is continuously monitoring my security state across compute, networking, storage and data, and applications. So when I click on compute, and I go to my virtual machines and computers, I get all of the virtual machines that are running in my Azure subscription. So I get a virtual machine by virtual machine view. And I can see my virtual machines that are running on-premises are going to be indicated by this purple icon. Mm-hmm. And my virtual machines that are running in Azure are going to be indicated by this blue icon. And I can see things like if I'm missing monitoring, if I need system updates, am I lacking endpoint protection, are there known vulnerabilities? And so to dive into those details a little bit more, I'm going to click an Azure virtual machine, and I can get instant insight into some basic info like where my virtual machine is running, what subscription it sits in, and what operating system it's running on. Mm-hmm. If I go back to overview, I can see an aggregated list of all of my virtual machines. And issues that have been detected on them. So we can see some things like there's been some endpoint protection issues, there have been some security configuration issues, I'm missing some system updates. And so I want to explore the endpoint protection issues a little bit more. And when I clicked on that, I've gotten instant insight into the fact that 10 of my 34 virtual machines in Azure are missing endpoint protection. I'm not happy with this, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take action. And when I click on this, the 10 virtual machines that do not have endpoint protection installed, they've been identified, and so I'm going to click install on my virtual machines. And the great thing is that I have this flexibility to use either a first-party Microsoft solution or mm-hmm. I can use a third-party solution to remedy this issue. And it's going to be as simple as that, so I'm going to choose Microsoft in this case,
okay. And
then that takes care of my endpoint protection issues. So thanks to Azure Security Center, I was able to get this visibility into the security state of my endpoint protection issues and take action.
You can imagine a scenario where you've got hundreds or thousands of virtual machines. A lot of these, I know that you've made this such that there's a lot of red. That
yes.
could stress people out.
Yes.
But being able to go and then make changes en masse and improve these virtual machines for everybody is pretty sweet.
Yep. And we know that these are time-sensitive situations. Mm-hmm. So again, if we can give that information to you in one location so it'll make it easier for you to act, we're going to do that.
Very cool.
Awesome. So besides giving you visibility, Azure Security Center also gives you several mechanisms that help you prevent against threats and that work to reduce your exposure to attacks. And mm-hmm. so one of those mechanisms that we give you is just-in-time virtual machine access. If you can believe it, the most common type of attacks we see for IaaS virtual machines mm-hmm. are RDP brute force attacks.
So people trying to remote desktop in and just
yep.
like 0.0.1, yep. 0.0.2.
Yep, the bad guys, not the good guys.
Yeah, yeah.
And the bad guys are commonly attacking management ports. So most commonly, those are RDP and SSH ports. And this is particularly challenging for our customers because they're trying to use remote access to get into their virtual machines to do good things like maintenance and management. And so just-in-time virtual machine access gives customers that control to open those ports for the bare minimum of time needed to complete a task. And then those ports are automatically locked after that time expires.
Interesting. So that was my question, because I'm thinking to myself, they're going to lock me out of my own account by putting in bad passwords.
Mm-hmm.
How do I find the balance between me being able to get in when I get in and then leave? I want convenience, but I also need security.
Yep, exactly. And so what I'll show you is that we give you the flexibility to identify the protocol for how you can request access and who can request access and for how long they can request access for.
Very cool.
So Azure Security Center automatically discovers the virtual machines that have just-in-time virtual machine access enabled and the ones that don't. So for the ones that are recommended to me when I want to enable it, I'm going to click on the virtual machine. I'm going to click enable. And again, because management ports are the most commonly attacked, those are the ones that we're going to recommend. But you can use JIT for any type of port.
Okay.
So I'm going to select the management port that I want. And this is where I'm going to set things like the protocol, where I can connect from, and the maximum time allotted for this port to be open.
Mm-hmm.
And once I've done that to my satisfaction, I'm going to click OK. And when I come back to just-in-time virtual machine access, I can either log in through the Azure portal to request access, or I can use PowerShell.
And yeah, so that was my question. Like, I'm saying open the door or leave the door unlocked for 20 minutes or half an hour.
Yep. And we will not allow you to exceed that. So after 20 minutes, when you're done with your maintenance, we will automatically lock those ports.
Nice.
So I'm back in my Azure portal. And for the virtual machines that do have it configured, I'm requesting access because I want to do maintenance or there's some type of management that I need to do. And I'm going to request the port that I want access to, where I will be coming from, and the time range that I need to perform management. So I know in this case that I've got a lot of work to do, so I'm going to keep it open for 6 hours and click Open Ports. And then after 6 hours is over, my management ports will be locked down, and so this will help me, again, to drastically reduce that exposure to brute force attacks and other sophisticated attacks.
It's such a useful feature.
Yes.
See, and this is the kind of, this is why I like having you on Azure Friday, because it's like people are hopefully watching this episode and going, I need that, and I had no idea that I have that already.
Yes, and one thing that I'd like to clarify with this feature is that this is a network control, not an identity control. So we take it that you've already validated your identity if you have made it into the Azure portal.
Right, but if you're getting brute force attacked, and that's the number one most common attack vector, is people just knocking on the door and pushing on the windows to see if they can get into your house. This solves that.
Yep, and as you've seen, it's just a couple clicks, and you can have this great protection.
Cool. Does all this exist today? Do I have this now already and I didn't know it?
Yes. So all of this exists today. As you can see in this blade, it's located under our Advanced Cloud Defense features. It's currently in public preview and it will be generally available very soon.
Very cool.
And it works for both Linux and Windows virtual machines.
Because it's at the network layer, doesn't matter.
Yep.
Use whatever ports you want.
Yep. You got it. So the last thing that I'm going to be showing you is how Azure Security Center uses intelligence to detect threats, and then ways that we can respond to those threats.
Okay.
So under detection, I'm going to click Security Alerts, and Security Center prioritizes those alerts detected, as you can imagine, by color. So red means severe, blue is not as severe, and we can see by this icon that it is a single incident that's been detected. But if I want to look at a group of related incidents that have been detected in my environment. I'm going to let this load for a minute, but I'm going to see this icon. And so to find out more information, I'm going to click on the security incident that's been detected, and I can get a short description of what happened, where it was, the environment that it was running on, but I still want more information. So I'm going to continue my investigation, and I'm going to get even more information. So it's going to take me to my investigation path, which is a visual an interactive experience to walk through the incident that was detected.
Wow.
So we can see in this section that this is my investigation path. So it's going to track the steps that I take to explore this incident. But if I want a more visual and interactive way, I have the bottom of this graph to track it as well.
That's really actually pretty cool.
We think so. So I first see that the security incident's been detected. I see that it's been a successful RDP brute force attack. And it's targeted this Contoso web computer. Mm-hmm. And what I can do here is I can add this Contoso web server and the other things that I'm going to click on as I'm investigating to my investigation path. So right now I'm saying this is not related, but I want to make it related and add a reason why and apply. And so it will be a part of my investigation path.
Wow, it's almost it's like a notebook for keeping track of these incidents
exactly.
So that other people can come in and join you in the investigation.
Exactly. And then with my virtual machine, I can also take advantage of the exploration, which is an assessment of different security activities that have happened in this incident.
Mm-hmm.
So what I will see is that one of my users, Abby Becker, she has added herself to be an administrator. And so right away, something's going off in my mind that this is suspicious.
Mm.
So I want to explore a little bit more. So I'm going to click on Abby. And I'm going to see a couple things. The first thing that I'm going to see is that she signed on from an unfamiliar account. So at this point, I'm going to assume that her account and her identity have been compromised.
Mm.
And I'm going to see that there is a suspicious process that was executed. So I'm going to assume something probably like malware.
Click a little bit lower. Suspicious process, gen hash, running in program files. Yeah. She snuck something on the machine.
Yeah.
Bad guy.
Bad guy, not Abby. So to remedy this, one of the things that I can do is to trigger a playbook. And what a playbook is it's a set of actions that will run that have already been predefined.
Right.
So you can use a playbook that's already been established, or you can create a brand new one that when you get an incident like this, suspicious process executed, you can go into the playbook, execute the or run the playbook, and it will take steps to work to remedy the incident that was just detected.
Very cool. So rather than me having to jump up in the bed at 2 a.m. and run in and do those things, Azure's going to run that playbook for me, and then I will investigate.
So you do have to manually initiate the playbook, but then Azure will do the rest. We'll take care of those steps.
Very cool.
Yep.
All right.
So that is the investigation path with Azure Security Center.
Cool. So we've seen a number of cool things with Security Center, some of which are free and always will be free.
Yes.
Other ones are at the standard level.
Yep, standard tier. Our pricing information is on our website. But like I shared at the beginning, it's free for the first 60 days, so you can get that full experience of what these features are like.
Very cool. Thanks so much.
Awesome. Thank you.
I am learning all about Azure Security Center here on Azure Friday.